So I just got approved. For more videos like this one, hit that subscribe button. But for now, let's go ahead and get into the video. What's up, guys? It's Jay, and welcome to Flashpoint, where we're all about credit, credit cards, and other finance tips. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. Also, give this video a thumbs up. It really helps me out. And comment down below with your thoughts on this video. I really appreciate it. Also, guys, do not forget that I am doing a giveaway of a $100 American Airlines gift card once I reach 1,000 subscribers. So all you have to do is like, subscribe, and comment on the videos. So if you haven't done so already, please be sure to do that. I really appreciate it. So, like I said in the beginning, I was just approved. That's pretty vague, right? So anyways, I've been on this run of business cards lately. I've been okay lately with taking these hits on my credit for business cards. And the reason for that is because these business cards have some of the highest sign-up bonuses out there, and they do give you a lot of value. So I just finished my run of Chase business cards. I have completed the Chase Sapphire Preferred, the Chase Ink Cash Card, and now I was just approved for the Chase Ink Unlimited Card. So that card comes with a $500 cashback bonus after spending $3,000 in the first 3 months. I actually have a pretty big purchase coming up, so hopefully I will get the card pretty soon because I would like to use it for that specific purchase just so I could hit that minimum spend off of one purchase, so that'd be pretty awesome. So this card is just like the Chase Freedom Unlimited, where you get 1.5% cash back on all your purchases, no matter what. There are no extra added, you know, categories to earn higher points or anything with this card. It's only a cashback card, but I'll tell you why I signed for it here in a bit. I just want to finish explaining. And it gets you 1.5% cash back on all your purchases. So basically, the reason why you want to use one or the other of these cards is because if you're using the other cards and it's not in those bonus categories, you're only going to get 1 cent. So if you use these 1.5% cash back cards, you're going to get 1.5 points per dollar spent on all your purchases, no matter what. So I got this card, guys, because it does have that $500 cashback bonus. And one thing you guys must know is that if you pair it with a Sapphire card, Sapphire Reserve Preferred, or the Chase Ink Preferred, then you can transfer that $500 cash back into 50,000 Ultimate Rewards points. And you can use that. That can get you a ton of stays at a Hyatt. That can get you probably, depending where you are, round trip for two, somewhere to Mexico. So that's why I applied for it, guys. And I actually applied for another card about a day later, and it was for a specific purpose. I also do have another purchase to make that will help me hit that minimum spend. I'm not gonna reveal that until the card actually comes in. So I am going to let you guys know that I am now at 524. At the making of this video, I am at 524, and I will have to wait until at least November. No, take that back. I will have to wait at least till September to be able to apply for another Chase card, but I think I might slow it down now. The only reason why I applied for this card was because I wanted to boost my credit score back up after taking these hits from these four business cards that I applied for, basically all in a row. So I applied for the Marriott Bonvoy business card, which had the 100,000 point signup bonus. I applied the day before the promotion was gonna go away. Now you see the Marriott Bonvoy bonus, it's at 75,000 points, and that's like, eh, you know? So anyways, then from there, I went to the Chase Ink Preferred, got approved, got the 80,000 point signup bonus. Then I went to the Chase Ink Cash Card, got approved, got the 50,000 point signup bonus, because like I said, the $500 cash back transfers into 50,000 Ultimate Rewards points. So, and then now I took the hit with the Chase Inc. Unlimited card. I waited about 48 days before I applied for this one. I would recommend not going any less than that, or maybe even 45 days, just to be on the safe side, because you don't want to look suspicious and you just don't want to try to game chase. You don't want to get on their bad side, because they could potentially just lock you out from ever being able to get their credit cards ever again. And that's not what you want to do. You don't want to get locked out from Chase cards, because you know, you can get a lot of free travel just from their ecosystem alone. So I would suggest that you guys wait at least 45 days minimum before you try to apply for the business cards. And right now, it hasn't changed. They still have the high signup bonuses of 80,000, 50,000, and 50,000. And you put that together, that's 180,000 bonus points that you could get just from three cards. And two of them have no annual fee. So that's also what I like about this Chase Inc. Unlimited card. It has a no annual fee. So obviously I'm gonna have it for the lifetime of the card, or until Chase decides that they don't want me to have it anymore. Whatever it is, as long as I get the bonus, because I know I can hit the minimum spend, and I'm good with that. So I'm definitely gonna be able to start maximizing the amount of points that I get on a daily basis, no matter what, because of that 1.5% cash back. So yeah, guys, so to go back to the other card that I applied for that put me in at 524 now, I got approved for $10,000 right off the jump. They basically approved me within a couple of seconds from applying. I'm sure you guys might be able to know who I'm talking about, what credit card company I am talking about, because I got approved pretty quick. It was about 20 seconds. So yeah, I'm excited about that. It's gonna give me some status for one of my upcoming trips. So I'm excited about that as well. So if you haven't already done so, guys, if you're planning on applying for any of the cards, just check out the description below. And I would really appreciate it if you use the links that I have down below, because it really helps the channel out. And that's one way to support the channel out without having to kind of give your own money away. So I really appreciate it, guys. And again, don't forget about my $100 American Airlines gift card. And that'll conclude today's video, guys. For more video updates, hit that subscribe button. If you found this information to be helpful, give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. Share it with your friends. Drop a comment down below to let me know what you think about the Chase Inc. Unlimited signup bonus and the Chase Inc. Unlimited card in general as a whole. I would really like to know what you guys think about it. So drop your comments down below. Don't forget to hit the bell notifications down in the bottom left corner, so that way you guys can stay up to date for whenever I drop my next video. Be a good person, be safe, be smart, and remember, credit is your life. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.